Hello Gophers, and welcome to our new video where we'll be learning about how to create a middleware which will help you in authorizing a user. Now in our previous video we have already seen how we can create a gRPC client to call the server to validate our token. In this video we'll be extending the same method and putting that method into the domain related services which we have already created to validate the user request that we have received on our server. In case you have not watched our last video where we have created a gRPC client and created a gRPC server, feel free to click on the I icon on the top where I've linked both the videos to create a gRPC server and gRPC client. So before wasting any more time, let's go to the code and start understanding how we can create that middleware which will help you authorizing a user on the domain related services from the authentication service. Now in one of my domain related service, that is employee service, I have created another package by the name of middleware. Now this package will contain all the middlewares that we would create going forward. Right now this middleware that I have created is just validating the token that we receive from the request. Now in this middleware, I have an init middleware which will help me in creating a connection or a channel to my gRPC server. Now if you notice, I have already created a connection or a channel to my gRPC server, and once I have a successful channel, then I have created a gRPC stub from the server that I am using as a gRPC server. Now in this init method, when I have the gRPC stub initialized, now this initialization part is done. Now there is a method that is creating the middleware, authorization middleware, which would return the gin handler function. Now over here, what I have done is I have taken out the API key, that is the token. If the token string is empty, then definitely we are unauthorized and user is not having access to get into our APIs. I have printed the token for our validation that we have received the token. And then what I have done is I've used the validate client, the gRPC stub, to validate, and I've called the simple validate method and send in the token to that authorization server. Now once I receive a success from there, that is no error from there, then that means I have got the token valid, and now from the token I will take out the data and keep that in the context object of the gin framework. Now this context object is shared between all the handlers so that whenever your API is received, you have that context object, and through the context object you can get out all the data related to the user who is trying to access your APIs, and you don't have to validate or open the token again and again to get the data of logged in user or the user who is sending in the request. Now once this middleware is ready, we need to register this middleware with the gin framework or the APIs that you want to have this middleware working on. So what we can do is, first, before creating the API server or anything, you just have to initialize the middleware so that the stub and the connection or the channel to your gRPC server is activated. Now this middleware is then used on the gin APIs or the group of APIs that you are creating. So you have registered the middleware there. Now you don't have to worry about anything. It's just on every APIs that we create, this middleware would be executing and it would validate if the token is present or not. And if the token is present, is it a valid token or not? Now let's go ahead and run our servers. So this is my employee server running on port 8081. This is my login server that is running on port 8082. And this is my gRPC server that is running on port 8080. Now let's go ahead and run the login API to get the token first. Now this is my token that I have received from the login API, the login server. Now I'm trying to hit my employee service with the new token. Now, if you see my token, as my token was valid, I have received the data of employees. Now let's try with a random number after the token so that the token is invalid. So you see you have received an unauthorized request. So that means your token is getting validated now. So this is how you can create a gRPC server connection from your domain related service to your authentication and authorization server. So over here we have received a little more security because you can keep the database containing the user credential or user sensitive information into a separate database and give the access to that database only to your authorization and authentication service, so that all the domain related services do not have access to that personal information of users. So with this, we have come to the end of the series where we were learning about microservice based architecture in Golang. So if you have liked the video, please do not forget to like, share and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Also press the bell icon so that you don't miss on any notifications of our video. We would love to hear from you guys if you have any comments or any suggestions in the comment box below.